Welcome back, guys. And it's been quite a while. Oh, that's some breeze. Bloods. So today, just getting my intro workout mixed up. I'm about to train legs, and this is also a prep update. This is a whole update. It's been a couple of weeks because it has just been chaos. We've gotten Django, that was the last vlog, and life has been chaotic but amazing since then. There's just been a lot going on, very, very busy, obviously on top of prep, and I think anybody who's prepped before knows how important it is just to mitigate any stresses and maybe not voluntarily place more upon yourself, i.e. recording YouTubes when you don't have time. So we are going to kick off a leg session. I have my tripod. I fucking remember it, guys, so we're off to a good start. Let's hope these bad boys are charged. Oh, they are. Score. FYI, these beat pods, yeah, way better for training than AirPods. They actually stay in your ear. So there's a little tip. Today is legs. It is quad focused, which means I have no cardio afterwards. Thank the Lord. And another good news, new low weight this morning. Jesus, that is horrendous. New low weight this morning hit 74 on the button. So that is the lowest weight of prep. It was kind of holding a little bit increase last week. I'm going to talk about that later. There was definitely some inflammation and kind of water retention over the weekend. But that has subsided and we have seen a drop. So we are sucking diesel, as they say. Right, let's get training. Okay, so first off we have leg extension and leg curl. I actually super set these just because with the leg extension here, the goal is to obviously get the blood flowing into the quads, get them nice and warmed up and pumped. And then with the hamstring curl, they're literally right beside each other. So for easiness and for time saving sake, I just super set the two. It's not like a strict do it right away, like in a few seconds, but I just, you know, let's be efficient here about it. Right, let's get cracking. I've done my warm-up set. Quads are sufficiently warmed up, and now we're actually going to go over to the Smith machine. So my gym does not have a hack squat, so check these out for a really good alternative. Hack squats are phenomenal quad building exercise, so they're something that I love to include in training programs for clients as well. So if you do not have a hack squat, do not fret. You can absolutely do them on the Smith machine. And if you have wedges for your heels, even better. But if not, you can always use some plates to elevate them, because we really want to drive knee flexion in a hip in a hack squat. I need food. Now we have the hammer strength plated leg press. Please use a plated leg press if your gym has that one. I think most gyms should now, but those horrible little seated pin loaded leg presses, give me the heebie-jeebies. This is going to be much, much better. This is a quad focused leg press, so I like to have my feet nice and low on the plate, because that again allows us to drive more knee flexion with the exercise, like in a hack squat, when we want to target our quads. Shh. to the leg extension. I was doing split squat, but with my foot on the ground, if anybody remembers the bus incident outside the airport, Scarlett. Anyway, my foot is still fucked. So split squat, apart from Bulgarians where my feet are actually off the ground, are a no-no for me. So I've switched that split squat exercise to the single leg extension instead, again targeting the quads. This is a quad dominant leg day, of course, you've probably guessed that. And then after that, I've superset of ab and abductors, which is also besides the leg extension. So sometimes, just for shits and gigs, I'll try set them. Let's finish this fucking leg day. Is there ever any glamorous ladylike way to get into an adductor machine? I'm yet to find one. The prep brain, lads, is real. Fats were lowered this week. That's a discussion for later. And the brain has left the building. And we are finished. I'm using these little pads. I'll show you what they are. Every gym girl should have them. Oh. Nip and Fab, it's the glycolic range, so it just helps keep your skin cleared, you know, because I go home and have shower there, so if you're not showering straight away after the gym, you just want to make sure all the dirt and, you know, germs and sweat and everything is off, so nice little tip to have them in. Yeah, so let's go home, eat and chat prep. Hi, home, fed, watered and ready to chat prep. This horrendous. This has just gotten worse and worse. That's from bloods, guys. I think she was new. Fuck, that's so bad. Holy shit. Anyway, let's chat prep. Hit a low weight this morning, which is exciting. So 74 kilos on the button. I'm just going to send Meg over all my photos. So yeah, I can't believe we're actually like under 8 weeks out now. So here is the fucking hard part. Like, here is grind time. Really happy with, like, what progress and results we've seen so far. So that's 8.5-ish kilos down since the start of prep. So about 12 weeks. Not too bad, but I definitely have another 6-ish plus to go, for sure, because my last stage weight bikini was just under 65, so 64.9. Now Meg doesn't think we'll have to go that low, because I have spent so much time, you know, like out of a deficit and building muscle, away from, you know, diets and stuff, and during my bulk phase, like that lasted the guts of 8 months. And I only had one mini cut in that, so definitely did sound to me doing it that way. So I'm just excited to see myself when I'm not flat. I'm going to show you pictures here of how things are looking, and like obviously I've gotten leaner, like you can see that, but I'm also kind of, well, very flat. But we're just at that stage of prep, right? Like, you're not avoiding not looking like that. So yeah, that's kind of where we're at looks wise. And as I said, so there's another 4, I could be 8 kilos to come off realistically. So the next 8 weeks, I'm really aiming to drop a kilo a week, and get as much fat off for this first show as possible. We do have 4 weeks in between the shows, but like ideally I don't want to be dieting a lot in those 4 weeks because they are tough. I've done it before. Mind frame wise, incredibly difficult to do the show and then wait 4 weeks instead of just doing, right, okay, I have a show next week, I'm back in it, and you know, like, you have to keep yourself I can't even say motivated, you just have to keep yourself fucking sane for the month, and that is actually really hard, because food is low, energy is low, fatigue is there, mood is low, you're not functioning very well. So I'd ideally not like to be on incredibly low calories, and really trying to get a lot of fat off in between shows. Speaking of calories, we've had a drop. I am now into the 1500s and 1600s. Ugh. Puke. Not nice. Not nice, but that's the name of the game, isn't it? So 74 kilos into kind of just under 1600 and just over 1600 then on training days. And yeah, carbs, fats, everything's gone down. So look, meals don't really change much. Lost by peanut butter on training days, but what can you do? So it's definitely a different approach to previous preps, for sure. Fat is definitely lower. But I'm not feeling as shit, which is weird. I don't know what it is yet. Maybe I'm just not lean enough yet to feel that bad. I don't know. I can't put my finger on it, but I'm feeling good. But then some days you get those prep brain moments and you're like, oh my God, I'm never going to be lean enough. I'm not big enough. I'm tiny. I do still think I'm tiny, and I know I'm not going to be the biggest there. Like, I will be outsized for sure, but I'm just trying to get things like posing, stage presence, everything like that, you know, perfect, because I can control all of those things. I can't control the size of other people. But that will be me the next round. So as I said in the last kind of prep update, this season, like, we're not going in thinking I'm going to, you know, win all the categories. Like, that's obviously, I would love to win and place and stuff, but you have to be realistic with your goals and your expectations. And I think that's when people get incredibly upset and annoyed. Like, the amount of competitors I watch have fucking hissy fits and throw a strop when they don't come first. And you can never control that. Like, you can't control who else shows up. You can't control the work they've done and how good they look. You can't control what the judging panel are looking for. Like, there's so many elements of that decision that are out of your control. You know, like, what are you going to do? You can't go in there expecting first place. Yes, you can aim for it and really want it and work for it, but you've no control over it at the end of the day. So for me, this season is very much, I would love to place. I would really, really like to place. And just really see what work needs to be done in the next off season. That's the plan. And I would imagine there's going to be a lot of size needed on the lower body, especially posterior. They just don't play ball like the kind of quads and like front of my legs do. We've definitely added some really good density there with the last off season. So I'm excited to see, like, the next one. Excited to push food, everything like that. But it's only really when you diet down and get very lean that you're going to see the real kind of test of what needs to be done and what's lacking and what your weak areas are. So, look, I'm using this as a learning curve. And like my first show, I used the reverse as like a little science project. I wanted to see what I could get my food to if I adhered, if I did it properly, if I did it by the book. So I like to kind of look at things in that way, and use it as an educational kind of journey and like a project. And when you look at that, I think you tend to look at things more objectively rather than getting fixated on things that are wrong with yourself and stuff, you know. Now God has asked me that 4 weeks out and I'll probably be crying into YouTube, but that's the logical and reasonable bit of my brain speaking right now, because I've just eaten and I'm happy as fuck, look at me. Anyway guys, that is the update. I'm hoping that I'll have another 2 kilos gone by the next one of these, which will be our 6 week out update. Oh my God. I do have another shoot, actually. I have a shoot booked for this day next week. And speaking of shoots, if that is in your plans this year, the free download link below is for my free photo shoot guide. And when I say it covers everything, it covers everything. So go check it out. And yeah, definitely refer to it if you are planning a shoot. Also with shoots, I do have an Irish group challenge and a Perth group challenge coming up. So if you really want to, you know, step up and just, you know, try something different this year, or maybe you've done one before and you want to do one again as a group, amazing. I'll also pop the link for more information down there. Thank you for watching. Remember, all my links are below for Nutrition Warehouse, discount code, my coaching, Instagram, socials, everything like that.
Hope you enjoyed it. Do give us a thumbs up, drop a comment, and make sure you are subscribed to see the next one.